you have if you...
George Zimmerman answered the question on everyone's mind. Would he testify?
Have you made a decision as to whether or not you want to testify in this case?
No, not at this time.
I object to the court inquiring of Mr. Zimmerman as to his decision about whether or not to testify.
Your objection is overruled.
But after a tense exchange between Judge Deborah Nelson and Zimmerman's lawyers, he made his choice.
After consulting with counsel, not to testify, Your Honor.
There was also proof in court Wednesday. You can learn a lot from a dummy. During one of the most surreal moments in court, both sides straddled a foam dummy in attempts to illustrate the conflicting arguments as to what happened the night Trayvon Martin was killed. Prosecuting attorney John Guy argued that it would have been difficult for Zimmerman to shoot at a 90-degree angle had Trayvon Martin been on top, as presented by the defense.
Would it be consistent, the 90 degrees, if Trayvon Martin had been backing up and the defendant raised his gun and shot at 90 degrees?
Then defense attorney Mark O'Mara grabbed the dummy to support his argument.
Were the injuries on Mrs. Zimmerman's back of his head consistent with someone doing this?
And on the final day of testimony, George Zimmerman's father, Robert Zimmerman, returned to the stand to address the screams heard on the 911 tape.
Absolutely. It's my son, George.
Is that an opinion that you still have through today?
Certainly.
In another important ruling, Judge Deborah Nelson will decide whether or not to grant the prosecution's request to apply lesser charges of manslaughter and aggravated assault.
Self-defense is self-defense to everything. There shouldn't have been a second-degree murder charge, and there shouldn't be any lessers.